Welcome back to online lectures. In the last sessions, we discussed about the enzymology involved in transcription and methodology of the transcription and process of the transcription. Now we are moving on to another topic, that is reverse transcription. So reverse transcription was first discovered by Howard Martin Deming and David Baltimore. And they discovered the process of reverse transcription and the enzyme reverse transcriptase. Coming to introduction, reverse transcription is the process in which a double-stranded DNA molecules are made from a single-stranded RNA. The name of this method is formed by its opposite direction to transcription. It also involves the presence of a reverse transcriptase enzyme. Here the enzyme is reverse transcriptase enzyme. A primer of about 18 to 22 bases nucleotide segments and the RNA's inhibitor involved in this reverse transcription process. RNA's inhibitor is used in most laboratories working with RNA to sequester RNAs. So what is the function of RNA's inhibitor? The function of RNA's inhibitor is to protect the RNA from the RNases. RNase is an enzyme that degrades RNA molecules into smaller products. Oligonucleotides and ribonucleotides are formed. Coming to reverse transcriptase enzyme. A reverse transcriptase enzyme, also known as RNA-dependent DNA polymerase. What is this? These are RNA-dependent DNA polymerase. Is a DNA polymerase enzyme that transcribes single-stranded RNA into double-stranded DNA. Normal transcription involves the synthesis of RNA from DNA. Hence, reverse transcription is the reverse of this. Reverse transcription is the reverse of this process. Reverse transcriptase was discovered by Deming and Baltimore in 1970 independently. They shared a Nobel Prize in Physiology or Medicine in 1975 for their discovery. The other names of reverse transcriptase is RNA-directed DNA polymerase, DNA nucleotidyl transferase, or reverse. Are reverse transcriptase common in retroviruses? Reverse transcriptase have following activities. They are RNA-dependent DNA polymerase, that means it synthesizes DNA from RNA. Second one is DNA-dependent DNA polymerase. It can synthesize DNA from DNA. And the other one is it has the other activity, RNase H activity. It can switch the or it can digest the RNA. So coming to the central dogma of molecular biology, where DNA undergoes transcription to synthesize RNA. From the RNA, the protein is translated. And the central dogma describes the flow of genetic information from DNA to RNA, RNA to proteins. Coming to the steps involved, DNA replication, transcription and translation. So this picture represents the central dogma of protein synthesis from DNA to RNA. DNA undergoes replication and it is transferred to RNA. From RNA, it is translated to protein. Coming to the reverse transcription, where the DNA undergoes transcription can produce RNA. At the same time, from the RNA, DNA can be produced by the reverse transcriptase enzyme. And again, this RNA can act as the transcript and can synthesize the proteins. Again, I am telling you that in transcription, from DNA to RNA, RNA to protein. In reverse transcription, DNA can be transcribed to RNA, whereas by using the reverse transcriptase enzyme, RNA can be synthesized to DNA. And from this, RNA can act as the transcript to translate the protein. So here, if we see the picture, from the DNA, RNA can be produced. From the RNA, protein can be synthesized. The same RNA undergoes reverse transcription to produce the double-stranded DNA. And the same RNA undergoes replication to form the another copy of the RNA molecule. We will see the general already we discussed in previous sessions, that is replication, synthesis of daughter DNA from parental DNA. What is transcription? Synthesis of RNA using DNA as the template. What is translation? Protein synthesis using mRNA molecules as the template. What is reverse transcription? Synthesis of DNA using RNA as the template. Mechanism of reverse transcription. After the RNA retroviruses enters a host cell, its genomic RNA will be transcribed into a double-stranded DNA. and then integrated into the host DNA. The RNA to DNA transcription is called reverse transcription. Here we will see the mechanism of the reverse transcription. The red color marked region indicates the retroviral genomic RNA, and it consists of 5 prime to 3 prime direction, whereas from the 5 prime side if we see repeated sequences followed by untranslated region of the sequence is formed. They are known as repeat followed by U5 region. U5 is nothing but untranslated 5 prime region. And coming to the 3 prime position, there we see another repeat followed by untranslated region, that is known as U3 region. So totally the RNA have repeat and untranslated region 5 at 5 prime region, and at the 3 prime repeat followed by U3 region is there. So next, coming to the second step, for this RNA the viral specific cellular tRNA first hybridizes with the viral genomic RNA at the promoter binding site. You can see promoter binding site, it hybridizes the viral specific host tRNA. So this tRNA provides 3 prime hydroxyl group. From there the DNA strand synthesis is extended towards the 3 prime direction. So next step, because of the RNA's H activity of the reverse transcriptase, it removes the RNA segment at the 5 prime end up to U5 region. In the next step, first jump occurs. What is the first jump? The DNA synthesized is hybridized at the 3 prime region with the repeated segments. This is known as first jump. First jump means the synthesized DNA moves are displaced from the 5 prime position to 3 prime position, and it hybridizes with the repeat of the 3 prime end. So thereby in the next step, the 3 prime hydroxyl group allows the extension of the DNA strand up to promoter binding site on the RNA. In the next step, you can see because of the RNA's H activity, the RNA is degraded on the RNA-DNA hybrid. Next, by using the short segment of the RNA, the polymerase extends the synthesis of the DNA towards the 3 prime direction. That means here the regions are U3 region is synthesizes and repeat region synthesizes, and followed by U5 region synthesized. And whereas for the tRNA binding site, that is nothing but promoter binding site, again synthesized here. So by using the RNA primer, DNA is extended toward the 3 prime direction, and the tRNA hybridized region in the initial steps again duplicated in the form of promoter binding site. Now here again RNA's H removes the primer and followed by tRNA. That means here all the RNA in this hybrid form are removed. In the next step, in the ninth step, the segment of the DNA jumps from the 3 prime end to the 5 prime location. So this is the second jump. The DNA produced at the 3 prime end of the first strand is dislocated and hybridizes with the promoter binding site of the another site. So thereby from which the DNA strand synthesis occurs, and the both strands are completed in their synthesis, and the double-stranded DNA is produced consisting of long terminal repeats at their ends. If we see the theoretical approach for the above explanation, the first step is retroviral specific cellular tRNA hybridizes with a complementary region called the primer binding site. Next step, a DNA segment is extended from tRNA based on the sequence of the retroviral genomic RNA. The viral repeats and U5 sequences are removed by RNA's H activity. First jump occurs, DNA hybridizes with the remaining R sequence at the 3 prime end. A DNA strand is extended from the 3 prime end. Most viral RNA is removed by RNA's H. A second DNA strand is extended from the viral RNA. Both tRNA and the remaining viral RNAs are removed by RNA's H. Now second jump occurs. The promoter binding site region of the second strand hybridizes with the PBS region of the first strand. Extension on both strands, long terminal repeats occurs. So we can see the just example how retrovirus replicates in the host cell. Example HIV virus. Now the HIV virus binding to the cell surface and fusion into the cellular surface, and the host genomic material enters into the cytoplasm. Within the cytoplasm, the host RNA undergoes reverse transcription, produces double-stranded DNA. Now the double-stranded DNA produced enters into the host nucleus and it inserts into the genome of the host cell. So in this case it is known as provirus. So now the provirus undergoes transcription, produces mRNA. From the mRNA, within the host cytoplasm, it undergoes translation and the viral specific proteins are synthesized. Now all the viral specific proteins reaches the host cellular membrane and starts to assemble the virus. And again, the RNA produced from the provirus can also act as the viral genomic RNA. So here the steps are: from the RNA, double-stranded DNA can be produced. From the RNA, through the replication, RNA copies are made, and the protein synthesized in the cytoplasm allow the assembly of the virus particles. And through the budding process, the virion escapes from the host cell surface by acquiring the envelope. So reverse transcriptase is used also to create cDNA libraries from mRNA. Reverse transcriptase has also been employed in insulin production. The commercial availability of the reverse transcriptase is greatly improved knowledge in the area of molecular biology. As along with other enzymes, it allows scientists to cloning, sequencing, and characterize RNA. Thank you.